In this video, I'd like to give an overview of the classical elastic boundary value problem. So the basic setup is you have some kind of elastic body. It's subjected to a body force, say little b. It's subjected to surface tractions t hat over part of the external boundary we'll call s2, and it's subjected to displacement boundary conditions u hat on part of the external boundary we'll call s1. So this is the setup. So we're given an elastic body, it's subjected to these boundary conditions, and the unknowns in the problem are the displacements of the body, the strains of the body, and the stresses of the body. The equations that we have available to us to determine these unknowns are firstly the kinematic relationship that tells us that the strain is equal to the symmetric displacement gradient. And then we have the equilibrium equations for linear momentum balance and angular momentum balance. So linear momentum balance, divergence of the stress plus the body force equals zero. And angular momentum balance is that the stress be symmetric. And in the body force, you can include the conventional body forces along with the D'Alembert forces. And then we have the relationship that connects the stresses to the strains, so the constitutive law for the material, which if it's linear elasticity will just be the fourth order elasticity tensor C acting on the strains epsilon. And if it's isotropic linear elasticity, then that's explicitly 2 mu epsilon plus lambda trace epsilon identity. So mu and lambda being the Lemay parameters. So the overall statement of the boundary value problem is given u hat, t hat, and b. So given some boundary displacements, some boundary tractions, and some body forces, we want to find the displacement field u that satisfies the displacement boundary condition. So in other words, it's equal to u hat on S1, such that the strains in the body are the symmetric gradients of the displacements, that the divergence of the stress plus the body force is equal to zero, that stress being symmetric, the stress being connected to the strain via the linear elastic stress strain relationship, and that the stresses acting on the surface normal equal t hat, the imposed tractions on the traction part of the boundary, so S2. So that is the complete statement of the linear elastic boundary value problem. And if you count it all up, there are 18 scalar fields defined. There are three displacements, U1, U2, and U3. There are six strains, the three normal strains and the three shear strains. And there are nine stresses to be found. Though really, one often says that they're just six because we already know, we have this statement the stress is symmetric. So three of the There are three sort of trivial equations, sigma 1, 2 equals sigma 2, 1, etc. So, but in principle, there are 18 scalar fields to find. So that is the complete statement, classical statement of the linear elastic boundary value problem.